Grindcast. I'm way too far away from the mic.
Yeah. It's okay, you've never done this before. So, okay, well, okay, hi, welcome to Grindcast, the podcast that's on the internet.
Yeah.
I'm Matt, and we've got...
Will.
And Jason.
Sweet. All right, so let's just... I don't know, we fucked around too much, let's get straight into news this time. So, starting news off, Lego. I mean, everybody likes to hear about Lego. What's Lego doing, Will?
Well, they're starting a new line.
Can't stop staring at your fucking hair.
They're starting a new line based on the 1960s Batman series.
So, what's it like? I've heard rumors of there being, like, a full Batcave.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's going to have, like...
A one-to-one scale Batcave. Because if it's not one to one scale, I'm not buying it.
Yeah, of course.
It's got that giant fucking penny in it.
I know how particular you are with your scales.
There's a model of a T-Rex in there. There's a big penny.
Well, yeah, from Gervais's.
I love how over the years, like, the Bat Cave has, like, it's, like, he's changed the shit that's been in there. Like, he had, like, these weird, all the weird things he's gotten, like, for solving crimes over the years. And then, like, there's one where it's just, like, this helicarrier of all the different Batmobiles, and they're all, like, on hanging chains, like the fucking, like, necktie machine.
Yeah.
They're just, like, hanging on these fucking clips, no, and he's like, which one will I use today?
Why the fuck does he have any of these things from the crimes he saw? Did he steal them? I don't think the people were just like, here, take this, Batman.
Yeah, Commissioner Gordon's like, that's that giant penny is evidence, I swear to God. He's like, no, it's mine now. but you can't...
I solved the crime, it's mine.
Well, I mean, you'll kill me, so...
But I won't, but I'll make you wish I did. 90%.
When I fight bad guys, I fight so well, they go to sleep.
You ever see the College Humor thing? Oh, my God. There's, like, it's one where he's... Like, Commissioner Gordon and Bullock, they go into a crime scene that Batman just ended. And they're like, the Penguin's dead. He's like, no, he's just sleeping. Like, no, he's dead. You straight up murdered him.
No, I fight so well that villains fall asleep after I'm done fighting them.
No, he's got no pulse, Batman. He's dead. I thought you said you don't use guns.
I don't.
But why is there a bullet hole in that guy's head?
He's like, wasn't a gun.
This isn't a gun.
There's also the one where, like, Dahlia's coming out and, like, telling him that she's,
Natalia.
Like, Natalia, yeah, sorry. It's like, yeah, I'm like Ra's al Ghul's daughter, and I'm Bane's, like, you know, girlfriend or whatever. And he's just like, hey, Bane, it sucks to be your girlfriend. It was great.
So, okay, so Lego. Yeah, I just think it's kind of cool for Lego to be doing, like, an older, like, theme. Because, like, most of their stuff they try to keep so current and, like, but now Lego's kind of getting a little nostalgic, I guess, and hitting up things that they didn't have licenses for.
Yeah, before. Or they go really weird. Like, what was that Bionicle shit all about?
Oh, well, nobody understands Bionicle.
People bought it, though.
I know, but nobody
That was going on for years and years.
Well, I also have seen some of these, like, the Star Wars ones they're doing, where it's just, like, put together figures of the characters, and it's just big, giant, triangular-shaped pieces of plastic. I'm like, that's not Legos.
No.
I'm like, that's like... a sharper edged version of Duplo. is Duplo still around?
Probably.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, isn't that the kid version of Legos, Duplo?
It's those larger ones, yeah.
Yeah, and then Mega Bloks was...
And then Kinects.
Yeah. Kinects, yeah.
They went over to Microsoft.
Kinects
made the worst camera money.
Kinects is like, kids love spokes, right? Everything's a spoke.
All kids are engineers now.
They all like Ferris wheels.
Guess what? You can make a shit ton of Ferris wheels.
How about a roller coaster? Nope, that's got curbs.
Cars that really run on wheels.
So, the only thing about Legos that astounds me is, as I've gotten older, I now have to ask myself, how the fuck did my parents buy me all this Lego shit when I was younger? You go in, it's like a box that's like 3 inches long by 5 inches high, and it's $150.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I'm like, it's just plastic junk. That's all it is. And there's one figure with like a smiling Lego guy in it, and they're like, hey, $150. Take you 10 hours to build it.
And now
you never build what's on the box. Halfway through, you're like, "Fuck this! I want to make my own."
And now, like, I had no idea how hardcore the collectors of Lego stuff is. Like, they're buying like one block that was specific to a set for like $20 for just that one block.
So they can do certain things. Like, did you see
crap?
Some guy built a scale model of a Star Destroyer out of Lego. I don't think it was out of Legos, but it had something. But it's also his gaming PC.
One to one.
Yeah.
One to one Star Destroyer.
One to one Star Destroyer.
Where would you even build something like
that? It's like, I build it in my house.
Where the fuck do you live?
It's on the roof.
Where the fuck do you live still is the question.
You got like an airplane hangar out back.
Yeah.
It's not big enough. Have you seen a Star Destroyer?
In person, no. It's in that airplane graveyard from Transformers 2.
No, yeah.
Never seen it.
Don't. You don't need to.
I know.
So there you go. If you're a Legos fan and you didn't know about it, now you do. See? That's why you come here. We give you all the news.
I enjoyed Legos when I was a kid. I'm kind of glad that I never got into the collecting of Legos, because it just seems like it's just a whole nother universe.
Yeah.
It's a mess.
Talking about things for, you know, people, like, to get the news here and everything. The studio that does Titanfall, I can't remember the name
Respawn.
Of it. Thank you. Respawn Studios has put out, basically, a help wanted sign on their website for level designers for Titanfall 2.
Now, what do you mean level designs? Like for multiplayer or just the campaign?
I think for the whole damn thing, they want to hire fresh blood into the company and they want new level designers.
See, the problem with that is, there's going to be a lot of people that are like, yeah, sure, I'll come help out. And then they purposefully do just shit jobs. And I guarantee you some of those shit jobs will get put through.
Yeah.
Like one or two.
Right. I filled out an application. I'm just going to remake the first level of Doom.
It's like I sent an application with just like crude drawings on graph paper of what I'm going to make.
I'm not even going to use graph paper. I'm going to use that fucking, ash deposit paper that you have, they print movie tickets on nowadays.
Yeah.
It's just going to be showing, it's just going to have this part of my hand in black, right on the corner of the paper. What's this over here? Oh, that's a base. Hand-looking base. So, I mean,
it's cool that they're, looking for fresh.
Yeah, it's funny because this was in the news, so I'm like, I've never heard of there ever being a news story of a company opening up their doors wanting somebody that... I'm sure it happens, but it's never been covered before.
Yeah.
This is like, as we've been doing this show, that's one thing I've been noticing is the weird shit that's starting to be put into the news. And that's because the internet is now your news source, so you need something every day.
Yeah.
To put out there. It's not like, you know, newspaper.
Every day, you need something every, 2 hours.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's so this morning.
Yeah. It's not like a newspaper where it's like, here's your articles, here's the big shit, and like some stuff for living, and this, and it gets put out, and that's your day. It's like, for the internet, it's like, okay, well, this was this morning, now we got to cover it this afternoon, and now here it is this evening. And in between there, we need other shit, too. And a lot of it's just like, oh, hey, you know, new game, Ark Survival, it's coming out. You can play the demo right now. If Xbox Live's working.
Yeah. Get on that shit, Bill Gates.
Because I'm pissed. I'm pissed, too, because I downloaded the demo, and when you start it up, it's one of those things where it's a timed demo. You have 60 minutes to play it. So I start it, and Xbox Live's down. Guess what I'm not going to be able to play? Because 60 minutes has long gone.
No. Is it 60 minutes per PlayStation play session?
Nope, it's 60 minutes from the time you start the motherfucker.
Yeah, that's bullshit.
Yeah, that makes no sense.
Yeah. So,
garbage.
I don't know. It's garbage.
It's garbage.
It's muck garbage. So, yeah. Shit. What is with me? I should just not do anything, electronically that has to do with money. I shouldn't. Every time I buy something on eBay, I get stiff.
Yeah, it's true.
I try to do something with Kickstarter. I almost get screwed with that.
It's a good thing I informed you about that.
You're like, hey, did you get your email yet? I'm sorry. So,
fuck it. Whatever.
So, on to other news. Speaking, we'll stick this with toys. We're talking about Lego. DC. Now, everybody knows Marvel had their Collector Corp thing going on. And for some reason, because I see C-O-R-P-S, period, I always want to call it corpse.
Stop.
It's like I see it in my head, I'm like, oh, Collector Corpse. Wait, no. Corp. DC is starting their own Funko-based box up now, too, and the start box is going to be the armored Batman from Batman v Superman. It looks nice. I will not deny that, but you know what? Funko, if you're listening, I just want to say this. I'm not made of fucking gold bricks. I'm so, like, go back to just putting this shit in store shelves and stop all this exclusive bullcrap. Because you know what? It's annoying. And from a guy who likes to collect these, used to like to collect them. I don't really like collecting them anymore. I'll get what comes in my Marvel box because I paid for a year of it. And I don't know. I might not renew. I'm not sure. But I'll take the exclusives from that. But you know what? Like, doing Target exclusives, Hot Topic exclusives, Barnes & Noble exclusives, BAM exclusives, GameStop exclusives.
I bet you can't wait for the
fucking Value exclusives. City exclusives.
Wait, what?
No, I'm making that up.
That would
Burlington
be awesome.
Coat Factory
that
exclusive.
That would be fucking awesome.
Petco exclusives.
Yeah. Amelia's Grocery Outlet exclusive.
What are you doing over there?
my anger is choking me.
While you're drinking your coffee, I just thought of something. Collector Corpse. That's what a coroner does.
Yes. Thank you. Y'all all have that visually.
Hey, pal.
I'll never forgive you.
You're on my phone now.
That is so fucking awkward to say like that.
It is. I will agree with that 100%. That's weird. You're in my phone now.
That's like when you walk up to somebody and show them pictures of your kid, and they're like, yeah, I got pictures of your kid, too. That's what you just did.
I got pictures of your kid in my phone.
Wow.
Wait. Internet, everything's out there.
It's all out there, man.
So, I'm just... They're over-flooding the market with all of this shit, and it's kind of getting ridiculous.
Would you prefer it be like the Amiibos, where you can never get them?
No, I don't...
All of a sudden, you get them all.
I don't want that. I just want it to be like, you know, hey, this is the new line for this specifically. It's going to be in stores. You can buy it at this date. That's what I want. I don't want, like, you can only get this one here. So when it comes out, the only other way you can buy it is if you go online and get it from a fucking guy that's selling it for twice the amount that it's worth.
Because there's even more, like, exclusives. I mean, there's Loot Crate exclusives. There's those, what is it, Entertainment Earth?
Yeah, there's Geekbox ones.
Yeah.
I'm sure eventually Geeks, what's that, Think Geek? I'm sure they'll start getting exclusives at some point.
True.
I can't believe This Is Why I'm Broke.com doesn't have Funko, you know, ones.
I love that website. I'm never going to buy anything from it, but I love it.
This is like, well, this is the thing that scares me with these, because I have too many of them to begin with, and when a company starts doing this much output, that means they're at their peak. And eventually people are like, I'm tired of this shit, and it's just going to hit. It's going to be like Beanie Babies.
Oh, that's just about to say.
It's going to explode, and you have to sell like 10 of them for $1 to get them out of your fucking house. And that's what, that's what I'm gonna have to do. I'm gonna be like, here, have all these for $2. It's all 150 of them. Just get them out of here.
150 or
I think
more.
That's what I'm at.
We'll see.
No, I'm not at 150.
To be a Funko Pop master.
Well, one good thing
gotta
about
catch
them.
Them all, Funko Pops.
One good thing about them putting out more product is the fact that they're not reprinting old product, because that's always a fear.
Oh, they're doing that now, too. Oh, no, don't even. Don't. I'm going to stop you before you even go down that yellow brick
you
road.
Real riled up.
They're already doing that, too. For.
Rustled the shit out of his jimmies.
Toy Story ones, Woody and Buzz. Jamie wanted them for the longest time. Now they started reprinting them in special 20th anniversary boxes. So it's the same one, just with a box that has a big 20 down in the bottom right corner. And you know what happened to me? I'm like, hey, why don't I just get you those? You've been looking those forever. I want the original ones. I'm like, fuck. Like, do you know how much these are? And I'm kind of being a hypocrite with that, because I have, like, one that was, like, $200 in there, but
I can't wait till this camera. People will actually see my frustration. Like, this vein will be like, like pulsating.
They'll see that, and then they'll see me over here reacting to it.
Just lounging back in a button-down t-shirt. Just like, oh, oh, you're like my Ed. And you're my, Max, what's the drummer from Conan? Max Weinberg?
Yeah,
you're my Max Weinberg.
Kevin Eubanks.
Yeah.
Really?
You're my Kevin Eubanks. Really?
More fitting than Max Weinberg.
Why? Say why, Will.
Because Jason's black.
What, black people can't play drums? They can play better drums than anybody I know.
Black people can't be white people playing drums.
Hey, if I wanted to, I could be one of those guys that are
you
like,
watch the
I'm
Pell
actually...
Show? You watch the Pell Show? He did it.
We're not doing this.
No, we're not.
I'm not sparking that
so,
hole.
You look over me and go... Well, you can't be Don Cheadle.
No, Don Cheadle can't be Terrence Howard.
I will tell you both right now, you can be and do whatever you want to do. I believe in both of you.
Thank you. Oh, my goodness.
Nip that right in the bud right now.
Bam.
So there we go. There's more Funko. If you weren't pissed off with having all the shit you had to collect from Funko before, now you got more shit to be mad about. So moving on to more collectible stuff. Twilight Princess HD.
I've already pre-ordered mine. I'm not ashamed to say it.
By now, if you don't know, they're redoing it, and if you pre-order it, there's a special bundle where you can get a...
Wolf Link Amiibo.
What are we going to talk about?
Amiibos!
Yeah! I think I have that audio clip somewhere. I got to find it. But, yeah, you can get a Twilight Princess Amiibo, or Wolf, the Wolf Link, with sexy-ass Midnas on the back of him.
Sexy-ass with a big
beauty. Dude, the internet blew up over that game. I
really find Imp Midna sexy.
No, I'm... Oh, my God.
I'm
going
to throw up.
She's got, going she's with got, internet culture. Jeez, calm down.
She's got that booty.
Yeah.
Stop it, Will. Your wife
Them
listens.
Hips don't lie. So, anyhow.
She's pog.
She's not white.
I'm glad you knew what I was talking about.
Good God.
The term is pear.
No,
you don't know what that is?
No. He didn't get what you're...
No, he didn't get where I was going.
No, I know exactly what you're saying, because Pog is fat-ass white girl. Midna is not white. The term you want is pear.
Okay.
Which is a woman that has kind of a smaller top and a wider waist and below.
Yeah.
You good?
Yeah, women are all sorts of fruits. Shapes.
I swear to God. Well,
fruit shapes.
I swear to God.
You don't want a grape one, though. You don't know what's going on there.
No, I don't know what's happening right now.
Nobody does. It's how the show goes.
It's the second episode of the night. It's the Monday episode.
Yeah, it's the Monday episode.
The shit just goes crazy.
So anyway, Nintendo released that if you have the Amiibo, it will unlock a special dungeon created... specifically for this release.
Sweet.
So that's one thing to look forward to. And if you didn't get on the train with buying it already, you can probably
pre-order it.
Really?
Because
when I did mine, they're like, oh, you got lucky you got in here and did this. I'm like, I know, because you're going to pre-order me a different game altogether. I'll walk in and get a Master Chief controller.
Did you shop at the GameStop?
I had to. I tried Just Press First, and they weren't getting them yet.
Yeah, I got mine off Amazon.
Well, see, I don't have Prime.
I don't either.
I don't get that 20% off, you know, drone.
I don't either. It's just a
20% off drone delivery.
I go on a website. I frequent a website called cheapassgamer.com, which I recommend.
Oh, yeah. It's been around since the early 90s.
Which I recommend because you can find some things, and if you're checking it, and they post something up. Sometimes you can jump in on things.
That's how we knew
gone.
About these secret discounts with Kmart codes.
Yeah.
Because they're like, if they price anything in the end of 4, you're getting a 70% discount. Yeah. It doesn't show it on there, but when it rings up, it'll be that way. And here's Will and I like, sweet, Last Remnant. With a 4.
Last Remnant.
And then I get home and put it in, and I'm like, yeah, that's a piece of shit. Like, oh, thank God I only got it for $4. So, yeah, there you go. Jason's going to love this Pokemon.
I was just looking at
giving a 20th anniversary 3DS. Jason is an avid 3DS collector.
Shut up. This is what it got.
Now, this is
he steals
new.
Other
this
pre-orders.
This is the new 3DS. The new.
Yeah,
3DS.
So is that one.
Is it?
This one. Sorry, I'm smashing everything.
Wow, Jesus Christ. He's dead.
Russian bear down.
Just let it go.
This is the new one as well, which has the better face tracking, a higher SD card. And
oh, okay.
Which I love. Battery. They could put excellent face tracking into that small-ass little machine, but you have the Kinect, and it's like, I can't find a body. Like, this is just looking for your eyes.
I can't see a thing!
Yeah, that thing just looks for your eyes. The Kinect has to look for your entire body, and it's like, where'd you go? Say Xbox. I gotta find you. It uses, like, echolocation.
It's a bet.
Xbox Polo!
Yeah.
No, I would say one. But yeah, the
one.
The new 20th anniversary Pokemon new 3DS is gonna have Pokemon Red and Blue pre-downloaded on it and come with two faceplates,
mm-hmm.
so you can change it out to have either Charizard or Blastoise on it. Yeah,
which I love.
I'm
how
a
the
Pokemon nerd.
I love how on the 3DSs, at least the new ones, how like the front faceplate. Like, you use the little hook end of the stylus, and it just goes like, boop! But then the back one, you have to actually use a screwdriver to get it off.
You mean those?
Yep, those right there. You need a screwdriver to get that back one off.
To do what?
For good reason, though, because the battery and everything's housed back there.
Oh, yeah.
If you want to switch your plates out.
Oh, yeah, that's what you mean. I don't. I like this.
No, I would, too. I
really
mean,
like
what you fought through to get that, I would never change that fucking plate.
I really like the, what the fuck was it, Triforce Heroes one that they released?
Yeah.
Highlighting crest on it.
Although that game was kind of garbage, but the system looked cool.
How would you know? You never played it.
I read.
I swear to God.
I read. I believe everything I read. Did you know the president's a lizard from outer space?
Oh, yeah, you should go back to Mars.
All of them are.
You didn't see the press conference where he removed this mask and ate those flies?
Jesus Christ.
It was pretty riveting.
I gotta find this article. Alright, in other Nintendo news, this would have been, since this is Monday's episode, this would have been past Friday. Metroid Zero Mission is on the Wii U Virtual Console. You can download that and play it. That was actually
really good.
That was a good one. I did play that.
The remake of the first game, but with more stuff and looked good.
That was one of those. That was one of those yard sale finds where I got it.
Yeah, I'm jealous of that one.
Somebody just had a whole fucking like the zipper pouches of games, and they're like $5. I'm like, it's like a blind bag grab and go. I'll see what's up. Throw it in there. I'm like. There's that. There's that. Here's Pokemon games. They're worth a lot. Just like, it was great. Yeah. I sold each one of those damn Pokemon games on eBay for like $35.
Oh, yeah.
Which ones?
It was like Sapphire, Ruby,
because if you
Gold, had, and Silver.
You could have sold those for a lot more.
I just...
A lot
I do the
more.
Bid war.
The remake ones, Soul Silver and Heart Gold, that were still being resold... I mean, that like GameStop for mm-hmm. full price. Mm-hmm. Some of them $60 for a goddamn DS game.
Well, fuck me. I could have got $36 out of it.
There's a lot of really high dollar GBA games. I had no idea.
Yeah.
Ninja 5-0.
You seem really disappointed with
Ninja
yourself.
Ninja 5-0 like is like almost
you
$300
look, you
now.
Look blown away like fucking like Doc Brown when he got the Plutonium.
Because there was a time where I'm like, I want to pick up some GBA games, and it's like the only ones that I can afford are shit.
Yeah. So there you go. There's deals out there that we'll let you know about. So we're going to move into a movie topic right now. Rumors about Infinity Wars, the character roster. Rumored to be, what's this, Will?
67 characters. We're getting into, like, Marvel versus Capcom 3 levels here. No, 2. 2 had more. Marvel versus Capcom 2.
2 was the better game.
2 was the better game.
I had more characters, too.
I just, like...
By, like, 30.
Yeah.
The higher up, like, pay alone for, like, the people they're going to have in this movie is going to be astronomical. I can't picture 67... Like, are they saying, like, most of them are going to be superhero characters, or it's going to be a lot of, like... sub-level characters, like, you know, like Coulsons and shit like that.
Oh, I'm sure they'll be in it. I think it's
Coulsons and shit like that.
Yeah.
Why? I mean, like, you got your
Phil Coulson level down here.
Well, you got your Downies and you got your Coulsons, you know, like.
And then you go down to the sub flooring.
Get some trading cards for me to sign.
Jesus.
See how you feel about Phil Coulson.
No, I just, whatever.
No,
I'm gonna get tons of hate mail. I'm gonna get
Zangief.
I'm gonna get Coulson hate mail now.
We're talking actual superhero characters, villains, heroes.
It doesn't make any sense.
We're not talking
extras. But they're just gonna be like throwing them in. Yeah. That's what I don't get.
It makes no sense.
There's gonna be one scene where everyone's in it fighting, and then it'll go to the people that people want to see, and that's what's gonna happen.
And every character.
And you know what's gonna happen?
It's like they're like Easter eggs. Like, oh look, over there's that guy. Here's that guy.
Yeah. You know what's gonna happen? They're gonna throw this shit in, and people that know nothing about comics, they're like, oh my god, that character debuted in this movie. Like, no, Cloak and Dagger have been around for a long time. Trust me on this. And that's the funny thing, because like they almost have to have those two in, because Cloak played a major point in that thing. Mm. They have to have Black Panther. They have to have Daredevil.
Warlock.
And Warlock. I can't remember the guy, the guy who could... it wasn't Pym, but there was another guy who could become a giant man. I can't remember what his name. Maybe it was just Giant Man. I don't know. Maybe.
Could have been Giant Man.
Could have been Giant Man. But he kicks the bucket. Yeah. Spoilers.
Maybe.
Maybe. I mean, they're not following this to like, the, you know.
To the T.
To the T, but. I mean, like, that whole thing, like, they're going to have to cast Death.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to have to cast Warlock. Yeah, that's the guy who looked like you a second ago when your hair, like, everywhere, and you're like, brah! You have to cast him.
Well, he actually has one of the Infinity Stones, I believe.
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
And, well, they'll have to voice cast, like, Galactus and all the super beings. But you got Spider-Man, you got Thor, you got, you know, I mean, most of those are casted... But it's everybody in the fucking Marvel Universe is going after Thanos.
It's like, maybe I could get a part in this.
doubt it.
If they cast a Death, maybe you can be Death. You could be Thanos' love interest.
Don't go banging Thanos on screen. That's not, that's not cool.
Because, you know, it's Brolin underneath all that.
Yeah.
You want to bang Brolin? Is that what's going
on? I never said that.
And he was in... And Brolin was in one of those Olsen twins.
Are you shipping me with Brolin right now?
I mean, I might if the shoe fits.
Shipping me with Brolin. Bromance of the century. Mm. Bacon and Brolin.
Yeah. Man's got a hell of a jawline.
He's got a hell of a chin.
Would it be Will Brolin or Josh Bacon?
Will Brolin. Sounds better.
Josh Bacon.
Josh Bacon.
So you're going to be the woman then?
I don't know how any of this started.
I think he'll be the power bottom.
Nah.
You think Brolin's the power bottom?
He's definitely the power bottom. Will's more like an otter.
Otter?
An otter?
He's like, thanks.
Sweet Jesus.
Sweet Jesus. So, yeah. This is just a rumor right now. Will Brolin going into some rumor.
Yeah.
No, the cast of characters is just rumor right now. I mean, I've seen posters where they have like Thanos in the middle, and it's just like this sea of fucking characters, like, all around like him and like his face in the middle. And I'm like, I don't know how they're gonna do all this.
It's like the cover for Sergeant Pepper's. It's
yeah. Instead of fucking floral arrangements, it's characters. So yeah, I don't know what their plan is with this. I don't know how many movies we have till that actually even happens yet. But because I mean, I know we got the Thor Ragnarok thing and all that. I don't know who's gonna come out in that. You know, I don't know if they actually officially release the full cast that's even going to be in the Civil War. I mean, I know Panther is going to be in it, and they teased some other stuff, but... I mean, like, I'm kind of on the emotional roller coaster with... Well, not emotional, but, like, I'm on the roller coaster with this that I kind of was with, like, Batman, Superman. I see something, they're like, Batman's going to be in it, and I'm like, my interest is peaked. And they're like, you know, Affleck's going to play him. I'm like, it's going down. And then they're like, well...
here's what he looks like in the costume and how he's how he acts. I'm like, okay, it's going back up. This looks interesting. I like this trailer where they're showing Batman's pissed at Superman. He's being reckless. I like this. I like this. Here comes Jesse Eisenberg. It's going down. It's going down again. It's hitting rock bottom. What is that?
He is way too damn short to be playing Lex Luthor. Lex Luthor's like 6'3", and Jesse Eisenberg's like 4'1".
Well, I mean, just like in that voice alone, it was going down. And then like Doomsday shows up, I'm like, it's good. The 747's got no jet fuel. It keeps going.
That wasn't bad.
And then like Wonder Woman shows up, I'm like, okay, the costume looks good. And then they're like, is she with you?
I thought she was with you.
Jumped, crashed.
We've gone sub-Coulson level here.
Yeah, it's sub-Coulson. It's going down, man. This is almost like Dr. Selvig level. No.
A sub-Coulson level event.
So, yeah, I don't know. I love the, all this speculation that people have over all this stuff, and it's kind of funny to see, like, where it rolls. Because, like, the whole, like, and we were getting into this, because should we do this after? Should we just do this as our discussion thing after we do request topics? Let's do that. We'll make that our discussion.
Okay. Yeah, we'll I know where you're going.
We'll talk about Star Wars after. Yeah. Don't. That's copyrighted. But yeah, I was on the same, like the whole like rumor mill stuff. I was like, how everybody thought Star Wars was going to go, and then you see it, and you're like, you were 10% right. You know. So, all right. Well, speaking of request topics, we're going to get right into that. I'm going to go with, we'll get this one out of the way because it was a topic I had, and it also just so happened to be a request topic. Cody gave me this one about, he was like, how mad do you think Fred is right now about the Hitman game being delayed? Which is funny because it's not only delayed.
It's now an episodic game, which means instead of paying $60 right away, you pay $60.
Yes, it's episodic, chunks. And it's also, anybody who pre-ordered it, they got their pre-orders revoked.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which I'm just like, this is why you sometimes don't pay for something that doesn't exist. And I can't believe they had the audacity to be like, well, we need to change this so all those people that paid us money, just take this shit away. And then they go like, remain calm. You know, it was something like that. It was like, don't get mad or, you know, like, we promise you you're going to get a version of this game. And like, what do you mean a version of this game?
That's a little questionable there.
Yeah. I mean, that'd be like pre-ordering all the Sonic 4 games and then you got two and you're like, what happened? Like, you're getting a version of Sonic 4.
This is false advertisement. I'm calling the Better Business Bureau.
They don't give a fuck.
They're just like, sorry, your call is very important to us. We're busy.
I will say in Fred's defense, like, I know this is like his favorite game franchise of all time. I've never played many, but like, I was watching the videos and reading about this one. I was like, I actually am kind of, my interest peaked about this one. It looked cool. And then this happens. I'm like, why is it the exact moment that I finally get interested in a Hitman game? They gotta go and change it around like this.
Well, I had no clue that this was a Square Enix title.
Yeah, Square Enix has this now.
When did they get the rights to Hitman?
I think it was actually a game or two ago in the franchise.
See, I've never really, and I'm sorry, Fred, I've never really played the Hitman games very much. I've heard good things, but with like billions of games out every year, I have to pick and choose what I play.
Billions?
Yes, billions.
What fucking universe are you living in?
You're definitely not current gen. Billions of games. Show me where they are. I'd like to play some good ones.
I'm not always the best with numbers. I mean, I do it as a career. I don't count. I'm not always the best with it.
Yeah, I don't count the. I don't count Infamous Second Son as a good game, Will. Let's throw that out there right now.
A lot of people like that game.
Well, it's good for them.
To take this franchise in an episodic direction isn't awful, in my opinion. Except
what they're talking about price point right now. Like, that's bullshit.
What they would have to do is loop around back and put it release it all together.
So season pass it is what you're saying. Which is bullshit, because they'll be like, you know, this game that would normally cost you $60, we just released it in a season's pass, so you're getting the full, essentially, probably 4 to 5 hours worth of gameplay over a year's time, and we're going to charge you $100 for it. I do not like that current trend of gaming. I hate it.
Yeah, everyone.
The old release me the fucking game and just let me play it.
We'll give you a little bit at a time, and you're paying for it, or you can wait and then get it all for one price.
Imagine if this shit happened back in cartridge-based times.
No, Jesus.
It's like, here...
It couldn't possibly work.
Yeah, like, you know... here's Donkey Kong Country 0.5.
You can play the first world.
And then you get 0.75 and then 1. Like, after 3 years, you finally get the whole fucking game.
That did...
In cartridge form.
That did kind of happen with Satellaview, but that was only in Japan, and it was a failure.
Well, yeah, I can't imagine why.
See, the thing is, though, it can work nowadays because of A, things are online, and B, people don't want to wait for a fully released game, which is...
I'll wait.
Anybody that's smart will wait, because then you'll get a full realized game that's actually not glitchy or broken.
Thank you for your kindness.
it's just so ridiculous that people are like, yeah, I need this game now. You got to release it. And then it gets released, and it's like, man, this is a shit game. Because they didn't have time to finish it. They had no time to polish, no time to work out bugs, and then you want to sit there and complain because you wanted it rushed.
But to pull the rug out from under pre-orders, that's...
Yeah, that's...
That's shiesty.
That's real bad.
All right, well...
What are you doing with that,
We're going to go to the next request topic. I also want to know how everybody felt about me putting that EGM Fun Factor 5.0 picture up. I love that. I had to look for that the one day. After like that whole conversation that Ben put up, I was like, I need this. I
want that on the t-shirt.
I know. I wish I could like ask them, like, can I use this for like a logo thing with my podcast?
They might not have it copywritten. Who knows?
Who knows, yeah. All right, so this comes from Justin Hubler. Name dropping. I do that if you know.
Justin.
We did get a Fun Factor 5.0.
So. Justin, seriously, if you want a shirt, you got to text me.
Yep. So, we got, how about a discussion on the lack of sportsmanship in professional sports, i.e. the Pittsburgh game this past weekend.
Oh, that was nasty.
So
everyone got injured.
I didn't get to see it, but I just heard, like, everybody got, like, it was, like, wrecks all over the place.
Everybody in the Steelers team was killed on the field.
Shit.
They had to replace them with animatronics. It's really scary.
Who won, though?
The animatronics.
Pittsburgh.
See, that's, you can't stop them.
The Bengals, gave them the game. The Bengals are like, oh, shit, we're the Bengals.
Like, no, see, the funny thing is, with the Steelers, for some reason, the Bengals always give us a run for our money when we play them.
Yeah.
It's weird. There's my 2 cents. And this is Matt with sports.
Yeah, Roethlisberger got, like, they were saying the hit was dirty, even though it kind of wasn't. It's the way he got up, and he kind of stepped on Roethlisberger's shoulder.
Yeah.
That's what really fucked him over. And it was like, no, the hit was real dirty, and he needs to be fined, and blah, blah, blah. The hit was exactly the way it's supposed to be. He didn't, like, grab him by the head or anything. He hit him normally and fell, which is what you're supposed to do.
If you go back and watch old NFL films of, like, guys back in the early 80s, late 70s, those hits, people got paralyzed.
People got killed.
People got straight up murdered out there, you know, and...
You gotta get used to this feeling.
Yeah, I know.
I don't like it.
Whatever.
Throw it out.
But, yeah, I mean, to say that some of those hits were, you know, kind of... You know, cheap or whatever. Unsportsmanlike conduct in sports has not, it's not a new thing at all.
Not even a little bit.
I will say, I think one of the worst moments of this past year as far as unsportsmanlike conduct was the Jose Bautista bat flip in the playoffs, where he literally, like,
Batista's playing baseball.
Shut that thing. Yeah, Dave Bautista, full Drax makeup.
God, he is just a jack of all trades, isn't he?
He's a jack.
Who thought you just had muscles, you could do everything?
Dwayne Johnson.
It's true. He's even got more muscles than God right
now. Dwayne Johnson played football. Not in the NFL. Yeah. Played in Canada.
So did Terry Crews.
Yes, he did.
And while he was on his team, I believe it was the Vikings, he painted pictures of his teammates to help pay for things.
Now he's doing Old Spice commercials.
And he's doing everything.
Brooklyn Nine-Nine, which is a funny show.
That's right, he is on that.
Yeah.
Okay, the last part of his request. Say you win this $1.5 billion lottery. What is your first nerdy purchase? I've got mine.
You want me to go first? You
go guys, for it. Yeah.
I will buy an actual working replica of the 1980 Batmobile. The Keaton one.
You're the worst.
Okay. I will drive that motherfucker everywhere. Even if it doesn't work in snow, I'll be sliding all over
you're
the damn
getting
place.
You're pulled over so quick.
No, there's a guy out west that actually makes road legal versions.
I know,
of it.
And I've seen him. I'm saying
there's like
you would get pulled over. I guarantee.
Oh yeah, I'll be in the car like da 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 da. Like
you did that.
Like running people
out back and just.
I'll be driving it like Danny DeVito did in Batman Returns.
Well, that you can afford to drive it that way when you're using an arcade machine.
If I got $1.5 billion, I'm buying my way out of jail. That's the way I see it.
Can't buy yourself the happiness that you want.
I will buy that car, though, because I've loved that version of the Batmobile, and ever since I knew that this guy made them, you could buy them, I wanted one. And it's so funny, too, because, like, he actually has Gatling guns that come up out of the front, but they blow bubbles. And I just think that's the funniest fucking thing ever.
This is
like, that's my bubbles.
I guarantee you, now that you mention it, it's not really something that I'm a super big fan of because I don't really care about mecha, but I would definitely buy
the giant fucking robot that
you can ride that has Gatling guns that fire when you smile. Is road legal. And what else does it fucking do? It has like a water cannon. That thing is so badass.
I want an actual working Voltron that I can live in.
You're asking for too much right now.
Yeah.
And every time
it breaks down, just get the fucking Megazord there.
Every time it breaks down, it plays that theme song. It's like, dun, 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 and then I can get in the like the Tiger and then like go to get groceries.
It would not work. Here comes Matt again in that goddamn Tiger.
That can't be street legal.
Fucking earth shaking.
Why would it be bounding?
You never watched Voltron? They bound like real tigers.
I've seen Voltron in real life.
They can
rattle
and everything. No, I will. I got $1.5 billion. They're gonna work exactly how I want them.
You're
gonna
get engineers to make you a Voltron.
Fucking right.
It's not gonna work. They made a fucking Gundam in Japan. It just stands there and then shoot fucking lasers.
Well, that guy didn't have $1.5 billion.
Japan has plenty of money.
Not that company that made that.
Japan made the damn statue.
I'm
going
to walk in, it's like one-to-one scale, as it works in the show, and I want it to split into pieces and play the theme song and growl. And they're like, well, where's the dough? Just throw out, like, make it rain with, like, bundles of cash, like, in rubber bands.
What you do is you get a cannon that shoots out.
Okay, t-shirt cannon.
Exactly. And they'll be like, did you just shoot $1 billion at us?
It's like, no, I just shot $100 million. There's more where that came from.
When I start seeing
this t-shirt
some results.
Cannon. I want a one-to-one scale of Bender statue of him saying, remember me, and shooting fire out.
That is way more than you could ever afford.
Remember me. Because
remember, there's also a casino in the basement filled with liquor and snakes.
I totally want that.
Yeah.
Again, Will, your turn. Come on. Let's go.
I would buy the skull of F.W. Murnau. No, no. That's mentioning from an earlier episode. Nobody cares. It's funny. My wife and I were talking about this the other night, and she's thinking through the things that she would want to buy if we had won the money. And one of her first ideas was creating an ultimate man cave for me. With, like, all the systems and complete collections of systems.
You're
going to
get a cave of men?
I'm going to have a cave of Brolins. No.
Will Brolin. His cave of fun.
But I would...
Jason's gone.
I would absolutely love... like, maybe I'm thinking small here, but I would love, like, a home theater. Like, an actual, like, I've got the seats that, like, recline and everything like that.
No, what you want is a theater that... What the fuck? Shia LaBeouf. Had.
Yeah.
That literal little theater. Just pull it out of the movie theater and bring it to my house.
Yeah, just take
mine
to
now.
My house. But I think I would want to buy... this is tough because, like...
I like your idea of the theater, but I want to go one step bigger.
Mm-hmm.
I want to buy one of the actual, like, things. Like, in a theater, I want to buy one of the rooms. So that's mine. And since I have $1.5 billion, I want to do it there every other weekend. Sean William Scott comes in and he plays all the parts of my theater experience. Like, I come in, he pops up, he sells me my ticket. Then he has to run ahead of me, get into the concession stand and pour me popcorn and a drink. And then he has to come in every now and then with, like, the light wand and be like, you know, how's everybody doing okay in here? You
know? Why him?
Because he's awesome.
Yeah, he'd be perfect for that, I think.
And every time he shows up, I'm like, country back!
God damn it.
You know what's funny? I'm sorry, and this is totally off topic, yeah. But I just realized this today when I was watching some of the season 10. I use the exact same news music that they use in the show, and I didn't even try that. I didn't even try that.
It was subliminal.
Yeah, I guess it was.
It definitely was.
I mean, I would probably have to buy a 1910 T206 Honus Wagner card. It's the one that Wayne Gretzky bought, and Todd McFarlane, I think he owns one too.
T2, good movie.
Spent like $0.8 million or something like that. I would want to have one just to say I had one, you know, and I would never look at it. It'd be in a box somewhere, in a bank somewhere, but, you know, just to say that.
I kind of like that idea too. Like, I kind of like would buy like a mint Amazing Fantasy 15, and then I'd like to buy a second mint one just so I can make a video of me ripping it in half.
Well, the value on the other one just went up, bitches.
I'm like, this is the rich getting richer, bitches.
God damn it.
And then you're like, you throw in the pieces of it and like a whole bunch of pigs just eating it. There you go, pigs.
And you throw it on a fire of my money. Like, so I'm keeping warm this winter, bitches.
I wonder how much it would cost to buy the actual mask from Hannibal.
Like, out of real skin?
No. Not of the security guard. From Silence of the Lambs.
Oh, you mean like the one he's restrained? Mask,
yes.
Probably not that much. You might be surprised.
Yeah. Probably wouldn't be that much.
Some of that movie prop stuff doesn't go for a lot.
No, but I would definitely be buying some original cells from the Batman the Animated Series.
Yes, definitely.
I'd buy the fucking
Another ones. Thing that I would do, which is really kind of weird, and it just came into my head, was I would start a company that would do a film restoration for older films.
No, you can't spend this on something that's going to make you more money.
This has to be...
It's not really... I'm not really going to make money on restoring some of that stuff.
He's going to restore movies.
So
that
you're just
going to
restore all
watch.
The movies that you want that you can't get.
I want a 4K transfer of Attack of the Killer Shrews. And I know nobody else is going to...
I do! Why didn't we go in halvesies on this shit? We could have won that money.
You don't want a 4K resolution of Redline Cuba?
Mm. You know, it's funny, like, all this shit going on, and I'm like, I never once said, like, I will buy better equipment for the show.
You know what I'm really surprised about?
What?
Not once did you say anything Godzilla-related.
I don't know what's available to buy. I mean, like, I'd love to have some of the original suits.
That hotel.
After they've been cleaned.
The hotel with Godzilla in it.
I would live there. In his face. I would just have
people
a megaphone and just be in the right.
Rawr,
bitch.
Oh, it's Witherson-san.
Oh, Witherson-san, the most honorable.
I am the most honorable.
Ah, bitch.
Why are you Dave Chappelle's Godzilla?
Yeah, it just sound like it, like, ah, bitch, I'm rich.
God damn it.
I would just live in a tent inside that mouth of that Godzilla. I'd live like a hobo, but I'm rich as shit. It's like, I own this whole hotel. Why are you sleeping outside in a tent inside Godzilla's mouth?
That's why.
Because I'm rich. I can be nuts. I can afford to be insane.
No, not insane. Eccentric.
That's true. That's what you
use. Oh, yeah. Once you get in that certain tax bracket, you become eccentric.
Exactly.
That's true.
It's like, oh, he's not crazy. Don't worry. Just because he bought all those rare Jellos and is now rubbing his animals in it. It's just something he does.
Yeah. He can afford to do that.
And the funny thing about the whole thing is you get $1.5 billion. You could bank $0.5 billion of that.
You wouldn't get that much anyway.
No, but I'm just saying, like, say that's what you have.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You could keep $1 billion, put the half away, and live off the annuity for the rest of your goddamn life.
No one would. I wouldn't. I'd be dead.
No, but I mean, like, you're living off the annuity
that
of that,
money?
And you still got $1 billion in your pocket. I would...
With that much money, I'm becoming Batman.
No! See, I had this argument with somebody about that earlier today.
You can't tell me I can't be Batman.
No. This is where I got at, because the guy's like, I would totally just become Batman. I'm like, you realize you gotta, like, go and train.
Yeah, I understand
like,
that completely.
Like, no, I totally would. I was like, no, I would get there... I'd be at the monastery for like a month. Be like, fuck this, I'm just being Iron Man.
I'm about to say, you're gonna go to the Iron Man? I wouldn't mind the training.
I was like, I'm just making a crisis suit. Fuck this shit. I'm gonna be Master Chief.
I'm just gonna be Phil Coulson. That's what.
Well, Master Chief's armor, if you get nerdy about it, was rated at like 3 tons.
I can't say Bungie anymore. 343 has like from the live action video.
Oh yeah.
That armor.
Maybe buy that.
I mean, it would cost probably a couple hundred thousand. It'd be nothing.
It might, but the other thing is I'm not going to fit into that because there's going to be 4 feet above me that
he's
I won't be able
not
to...
fucking... What are you? You can't... You're not like...
No,
nine,
even...
He's not 9 feet tall,
even
Matt.
Though they made the boots, like, taller so the guy that was in it could be that tall, the guy that acted in was still taller than me.
Yeah, but not 4 feet taller than you.
I'm sure he is.
Oh my god, the dude is not 9 feet tall, Matt.
How short do you... Still.
If you were 6 feet, Matt, it would be 10 feet.
I'm 3 feet tall, Jason.
You swear to God, Matt.
You were 6 feet, you would be a yard.
It's one thing for sure, I'm taller than an inch.
Shorter than a mile.
Give him an inch, he comes a ruler.
Yes, just like the devil.
Oh, I'm about to leave again. I'm done with this.
All right. So we're going to go into our Star Wars discussion before Jason decides to leave.
Yes.
You guys are insane.
I told you what I'm going to buy. You don't like it, you can buy whatever shit you want.
I'll buy a muzzle for you.
You can go and spend,
fairly practical.
You can spend all your money on the stuff that you thought I would buy so I can sit to be like, shit, now that billionaire has it and I can't.
The actual DNA of Godzilla.
I'd be like, Jason, got to buy that off? He's like, yeah, $2 billion.
Shit, I need a job. You can work for me, Matt.
Start saving up.
Would you still work?
Maybe not for a little while. But I think eventually I'd be like, I'm bored of this yacht living party on an island that I own lifestyle.
I'd take Donald Trump's job. I'd buy him out.
He'd buy Donald Trump. I think he owns more than a billion himself.
He'll give me pizzas.
I'd buy the rights to his hairstyle. Nobody else can have it.
I would buy the rights.
Nobody else wants it.
I would buy the rights to the Lonely Man theme song so I could use it in our credits. Because that is a hell of a loop that I can't find a way out of to get rights to. So, okay, moving on. Star Wars discussion.
Lots of spoilers.
Spoiler. I'm going to probably put something in the tag of this.
If you don't want to listen to this part, just put some things in your ears and walk away.
Yeah, if you're not one of the people that spent $9 out of the $1.5 billions or whatever this has generated already, spoiler alert.
It's insane how much money that's made.
Some theaters are still selling out.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So Will finally got the... He's seen it, so we can now finally all talk about it together. Let's start with gripes, because that seems to be the thing I have the most problems with.
I think you have more gripes than I do.
I do. BB-8, I fucking hate it.
I didn't think any way or the other about BB-8. He was, like, insignificant to me.
I hate BB-8 because I looked at it like a Pokemon. Every time it showed up, it's like, buy our toys! There goes one.
Well, duh.
Yeah, but the thing...
Gotta make that cash.
BB-8... Although there was a few scenes with him that just kind of lost it.
The thumbs up lighter?
Yeah.
Is it the thumbs up lighter?
The thumbs up lighter.
That was pointless.
Which the guy behind me, I thought he was going to die in the seat.
You had Giggle Man.
I had the guy that could not physically control his laughing behind me.
Just sweating back there, shaking in his seat.
There's a joke coming up, I can feel it.
If that fucking thing makes a thumbs up lighter, I'm going to fucking die.
It's like when Beavis ate all that chocolate and became the Great Cornholio. He was sitting right behind me at the theater.
That'd been great if the guy is even back there like this.
I will say this. I felt that Poe Dameron was so goddamn insignificant that when he died,
waste of a character.
When they said he died, I was like, whatever, I don't care. Goodbye. He's
and then the desert ate
the ship plane,
and it blew up after it blew up. That was the other thing I was kind of like, yes. How'd that work?
Because then they made it seem like he's definitely dead. And then he came back, and I was like, why? You had no reason to be
because
here.
We need to have a scene that shows that he can pilot. No,
they had to have him back so they can have more shadows of episode 4.
When, the trench scene again. Yeah,
I don't need that.
In a giant
room. To start the film off with him, I thought was an interesting choice because it establishes the thought in my head because I went in knowing nothing that this guy's gonna be important in this film.
Yeah,
and to not be at all basically. To basically bookend it.
I kind of felt that the old man was going to be more important than him.
Yeah, who the fuck is that old man?
Okay,
I don't know.
I had to research.
Okay,
because I had no effing clue. He's apparently was a Jedi like historian or something like that. That like Luke got together with after Return of the Jedi, and then, like, they were searching for the first Jedi temple together.
So he worked for Wiki Wars then, huh?
Yeah, and I had no clue who this man old man was. I'm like, why put that? That made no sense either.
See, this is one of my points I tried to make to somebody. If you have to search for answers,
mm-hmm.
then the movie failed at telling you a story. If you have to assume or create in your mind how this got to where it is, it failed as a storytelling movie.
Because with that, they're not going to loop back and explain who he was.
No.
Who gives some of the other stuff that's left open-ended, I know will flesh out.
There's a lot of stuff that wasn't in the movies because there was a person that wrote canonical books that take place right before it for, I think, Poe, Finn, and Rey. Mm-hmm. And the whole idea with Finn was that he actually isn't like this fuck-up that you think he is. He actually was an extremely good stormtrooper. Like, they were like, he's fantastic. There's no way that he can't, like, do what we need him to do. But they had a problem because he cared way too much about his squad mates than he cared about getting the mission done.
Which so they showed. They showed that.
Yeah. Not really. They just showed him, like...
They showed him not wanting to kill people.
Yeah.
Well, they showed him, you know, being upset of his fallen comrades.
Yeah.
And I don't think they ever really made him look like a bumbling fool.
No, I'm not saying they made him look like a bumbling fool. They made him look like he wasn't wanting...
Except when he said he was a janitor on the
yeah,
Death Star.
That was
I'm
a
just
going
to call it the Death Star.
That was a bit
I think
odd.
He may have just been lying there, though. I think that may have just been like...
He pulled a Han Solo on Han Solo.
Well, okay.
Because the whole thing at the beginning, which you wouldn't know if you hadn't read the books, the stormtrooper that, like, wipes the blood on his face, that was one of the members of the squad that he was in when he was training to be a stormtrooper. I can't remember his designation, but his nickname was Slips because he was a fuck-up and he always was fucking up. And he felt responsible for his death, which really broke him down even more to be like... I can't do this. They're letting these people die when they don't have to die. And as people originally started to call him TR-8R, who's actually another member of his squad, FN-2199, he was obviously upset about Finn betraying him because it was like, we grew up together.
Yeah.
We always had each other's back, and now you're just... leaving like this. But they don't explain this stuff, which is kind of disappointing.
You know what I want to know? I want to know how everybody knows how to fly everything, even though they've never sat in one before. Because there was that part where Poe was like, the TIE Fighter is like, I always wanted to fly one of these.
You ever fly
a TIE Fighter? He's like, nope, I always wanted to. And then he just takes off.
Well, he did say, I can fly anything. Cockingly, whatever.
Yeah, but that doesn't cover it. You know, I also want to know, like, Rey's like, oh, that piece of junk over there, and then they get in the Millennium Falcon, and she can fly it fine, even to the point where she can cut the engine, turn it back on and fly away.
They explained that because she knew the guy that stole it, bought it, and obviously she had to have either worked on it or...
I'm not buying it. She was a scavenger, too, so she knew the technology.
Just because you knew the technology doesn't mean you can fly it like, you know, Snoopy flying his goddamn
look here. The goddamn Millennium Falcon was like a junker in the original one, which is why they had the
whole
line.
It'd be like taking somebody who's never driven a car and put them in like a 1970s Buick with no power steering, and they'll figure it out. You know, they'll figure it out
over time, but not like in the middle of a dogfight and fly it through
a, you know, the innards of a Star Destroyer.
That was pulling out the thought that there's something with this girl. Yeah. She's got something.
Would you have preferred if they just died right there?
No, I wanted them to get in pod racers and race. Oh. Of course I didn't want that.
Of course not. Okay. One of the...
Sorry. Okay, fine.
We're going back to that scene in the village. That scene in the village with the old man.
Yeah.
When we introduce Kylo Ren.
That was pretty fucking badass. Yeah, when he stopped the laser.
How badass was that?
It was, but he could only do that once, apparently.
So do you want to discuss that?
Didn't see that one coming from a yelling Wookiee.
He was distracted.
He was distracted from killing his father.
He's like, my dad.
You want to discuss what I was talking about earlier? About the comic I saw where someone drew Kylo Ren as like a little kid or whatever, and Chewbacca's like helping him be raised.
Before we get into this, this is one thing that I also want to say. Most of the populace that's going to go see this movie didn't read all this outside stuff.
No.
That's what I mean is in a part of it's cool to get into this extended universe, but then when you also tell everybody you're not going to do it, and then you did it anyway, that's where you're going to have, especially like me, I'm one of that percentage of people that it's like, I don't know anything you're fucking talking about, and that's because I didn't read any of this stuff.
So you don't know about the bounty hunters.
Now if I go and I say something, then the person, you know, all those people that read that chronology of books and be like, well, you're a dumb motherfucker. You know, like,
you can say, fuck you. I don't need to live your life.
But that, I guess that's the main point I'm trying to get at is like, if you're going to make a movie like this, either go off of something completely new and make up your new universe or like, I don't give a little bit of more information.
Did a lot of it, I don't think they had to flesh, like, go back and explain a lot of that. I think it was fine. It was the old man's. That doesn't fit anywhere.
That doesn't fit. I wish I, like, you and what you're about to talk about, I wish I knew a little bit more about how Kylo Ren went to the dark side.
Yeah.
Because that's interesting.
Which actually is a really big story point that they don't cover, but it's written in books and whatnot, and this is where they got that whole storyline from.
Which I've gotten arguments from people who are like, well, they didn't explain everything about Vader. I'm like, okay, touche.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, like, you didn't find out about more Vader till, like, the last movie, or, like, you know, Empire, like, toward the end of that. You didn't find out that stuff till then, but at the same time, like, they're taking the mask off Kylo Ren. They're saying he's related to Han Solo, you know, like, all this stuff, and
pretty abruptly, too. Like, no build-up whatsoever. It's just like, he's your dad. Well, yeah, he's my dad.
Yeah, I prefer it that way, though. I don't want that whole wait till the last 10 minutes of the movie and you find out. It's like, you just built up to nothing? Thanks.
But there was no build up to it. It was just like,
yeah,
earlier we alluded to a family line, but you didn't really.
What I do like is the fact that in all the trailers, they made it seem like Finn was going to be the Jedi. And then they're like, now you're fucking with you. He just had the lightsaber because it had to happen.
And if you're still with us, this episode's probably going to go on a little longer than normal, because there's a lot of points to cover.
Yeah, like I was saying about the whole Chewbacca thing, the comic I saw someone drew, obviously, as a kid, he's going to be around Chewbacca. Chewbacca's going to get those feelings of like, I'm your uncle, and
so that's why he's like, I can't kill him, because...
Yeah, and then he's sitting there, sees him kill him, he's upset. And
he had a Point Break moment.
Yeah.
He doesn't shoot into the air, though.
That would have been great if he was, like, aiming and it, like, kills him. He's like, and then Finn and Ember just like, what the fuck is that Wookiee doing?
But instead of killing Kylo Ren, he shoots him in, like,
the gut,
the stomach, because he doesn't want to kill this person who he actually loves.
Which I learned from Crimson Peaks, that if you stab somebody right around the side area, that's not a kill stab.
No.
So Chewbacca knew.
You should have learned that from
Scream.
With Leonardo DiCaprio and Daniel Day-Lewis.
Gangs of New York.
Oh, yeah, that's right. They did that in there, yeah. So
if you stick them here, they'll bleed and bleed.
Scream as well.
Scream as well.
Scream.
So, I mean, and if you would have read that, seeing the movie, you're like, that's brilliant. They picked up on that. They used that. That's awesome.
But you would have never guessed that. You would have just thought,
in the movie, you're just like, man, Chewie's a shit shot.
And all throughout, the funny thing is, all throughout the movie, he's just blasting away perfectly fine, aiming where he needs to aim.
He's blasting off everywhere.
Stop. Nobody wants to see that.
You had to fucking make the motion, you asshole.
Oh, but yeah, there's just so much
that
could have been explained better.
And the thing, like, I almost wanted to scream out in anger twice in the movie. The thumbs up lighter. I'm also like, why does that fucking thing have a lighter built into it?
Swiss Army knife. Just like how, why did R2-D2 what's the word I'm looking for? A saw.
It's true, I guess.
Buzz saw in his.
No, I lied. Chest. There were three times when I almost wanted to scream. One was that. Mm-hmm. Two was when they're like, oh, it's not a Death Star, it's bigger.
Starkiller.
I got so mad.
Starkiller. Which was Luke's original last name.
And the name of the game. Yeah. In, Force Unleashed. Mm-hmm.
I laughed at that part because I was just like, you really just did that.
I got mad when R2 comes back. You know,
oh, that really annoyed me. Because
they're like, oh, he when his master left, he powered down. I'm like, what are these fucking pets? They have feelings now?
They threw a sheet over him.
Yeah.
What the fuck was that about?
They're just like, now he's a coffee table. Fuck it.
Man, fuck him. He doesn't want to move.
He's just sitting in the corner with a sheet on him.
It's like that fucking owl from the robotic owl from
Clash of the Titans.
Clash of the Titans.
Yeah.
They did that remake. They pulled it off. They're like, what? So it just gave up because what? They didn't have a sequel?
Yeah, pretty much.
Like, he comes back. So BB-8 really the whole time has the map of almost the entire galaxy except this one puzzle piece.
No. So R2-D2
has that. BB-8 has that one
piece. That's right.
Small
okay,
piece.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
So R2-D2
the piece that was missing
has the entire map, right? BB-8 has this, the little piece in the map. So, like, R2 comes back, shows the whole map, and BB-8 puts it in, and that's when you realize there's only five fucking planets and that one little piece that's missing.
So five planets. That's actually an entire, like, galaxy.
Okay, I'm sorry. To me, it looked like there were only five planets hovering in that
The problem
piece.
I had with that part, because I know exactly what you mean, I felt really annoyed by that, too. Why the fuck do you need the rest of it if you had the part where he is?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Just fucking, look, you don't need to know, oh, so we start here, and we go here. You have waypoints between...
It's not like, and I'm going to Duck Dodgers again. It's not like you need that whole map so you can make your bullshit travel route to go to it.
Yeah.
Like, I thought
the gem in the staff, put it in the sun.
Yeah.
Stop it.
I thought that the whole time when that came out, I was like, your logic with this whole scenario is flawed.
It's real. It's
BB-8's like, yeah, he's right there on this planet. Right fucking there. They're like, well, I'll never know how to get there unless I have the rest of the entire galaxy on a map.
I will say this, and I'm not sure if you'll agree, I don't think Matt didn't really, but I am extremely happy that the ending was with them finding Luke, because I do not need the second movie with them just going to go find Luke. Yeah. Fuck that.
Yeah, I don't need a, you know, two tower scenario.
Shut up right now.
Let's try.
No, I don't need one with them traveling long distances.
I get what
Luke.
You mean, but I like Two Towers.
I did too. I'm just saying, like, I don't need another like that.
You don't need a bridging the gap film for the second film.
I wanted my ending, which I will explain. Go ahead.
You want Empire Strikes Back again. You want a film that doesn't feel like it's bridging the gap. You want a film
that's actually
fleshing out a lot of plot points.
Yeah.
And, you know, when you look at the original trilogy, 4 through 6, A New Hope and this film are pretty much the same idea.
That's what I'm saying. It's just shadows of episode 4 all throughout 7.
Yeah.
It's a youth on a desert planet that watches two suns set, that finds a robot.
If the next film is anything like Empire Strikes Back, you already sold me on it. But if the last one has Ewoks in it, I'm going to have to say Nano, my brother.
You know why that happened, though, don't you?
Nano, my brother. What?
Why the Ewoks were put in?
Well,
the company was like, we need more merchandising toys.
Yeah.
So you got to do something. And he was like,
see what
no. It was like, well, you can't make the movie then. It's like, fine, fuck it, Ewoks.
What I hope happens is, like, they make almost, like, Empire Strikes Back, and they're like, well, we can't call them AT-ATs, so we'll call them Tatas.
AT-ATs.
No, the Tatas.
I swear to God.
The fact that... How they portray...
That's how I do it, but I know a lot of people don't.
How they portray Kylo Ren. I thought he came off kind of whiny.
Kinda.
They tried to do this stupid little, we'll try to make him sympathetic, but it really wasn't, he was sympathetic. He was just this angsty teenager who...
He's like, I just want...
Couldn't control himself.
I just want my old wrinkly face scarred Sith Lord to tell me how to Sith better.
I liked his anger. I liked when he was just like wrecking shit and stuff like that. But at the end where he's like, that's my lightsaber. And I'm just like, what?
That's the one that broke the camel's back for
you?
Me,
yeah.
The one where he walks in and she's not in the chair and he like cuts it in half. That's where I was like, fuck this guy.
That scene was actually pretty fucking hilarious, especially when they're like, nope, fuck that.
We're cheesing out of this.
Yeah, I thought, you know, of all the comedy relief in that, I enjoyed that the most.
That was pretty excellent because if they walked past that door, they're probably going to die.
Yeah.
But the ending I want, which I feel, and this is just me personally, I thought would make great.
You wanted Jar Jar Binks to come back, didn't you?
I did. So much. Mm. No. Yeah, high five on that. What I wanted was, I wanted the Starkiller to actually make the shot. Mm-hmm. Like, I wanted them to fail their mission. They shoot, it, like, Leia and all them die. Mm-hmm. The Rebellion takes a big hit. And then, between the time when they get the map that shows them where Luke is, Leia sends out a last-minute distress signal to Luke. Because there's, like, hours that go by in there mm-hmm. that you know nothing about, and you don't know, like, how close Luke is to this or whatever. So they're on the Starkiller. They're having the fight. Finn and Rey get basically incapacitated because, like, you know, let's give Kylo Ren more of a shot. He's actually more badass than they make him out to be.
He's an extremely powerful Jedi, but they make him seem a lot weaker than he is because he's not fully trained and Snoke has to come and save him
so
he can be the new Vader.
He incapacitates the two of them. Then they do a scene where the lightsaber's in the snow and he's reaching out to get it and it goes in the opposite direction. And then there is Skywalker standing there. And it just like, and it comes out like he just like, and it ends. I would have shit my pants. I would have shit my goddamn pants if that happened.
Why would
that
you
way.
Shit yourself?
No, because how perfect is that to set that up? The Rebellion takes a giant hit. Everybody's down and out. Han Solo's dead. Leia's dead. The only person left to come back is Skywalker. And you have these two people that he is like his last hope to teach them the ways of the Force so they have a fighting chance and maybe taking down the Order.
The Han Solo death scene, the way they set that up, was there anybody in the planet that didn't think he was going to die then and there?
I thought he was going to go home with Daddy and they're going to have tea. Some Lorna Dunes and a nice Earl Grey.
You know what would surprise me about that is if he really was, but then as an Admiral General Hux. General Hux? It doesn't matter. He's a fucking dickhead. If he came in and ruined the whole thing and tried to, like, kill both of them, that would have been the only thing that would have surprised me. Because I knew for a fact, because, let's just say it, Harrison Ford's way too fucking old to be doing three movies.
Well, he even looked like, I don't want to fuck you.
He hasn't wanted to do one since Empire Strikes Back, so.
Yeah.
But think about it this way. He had the, what the hell is it called? The Millennium Falcon, like, crush him, and J.J. Abrams had to try and rescue him, but he ended up getting hurt trying to rescue Harrison Ford. And the entire movie, he's just like, I can do the lines. I'm not moving, though. I'm just going to stand here.
You could tell he had a limp to his walk and shit.
I found it hilarious whenever they're outside in the cold areas, he always had a jacket on. Yeah. And everyone else is like, it's not that cold.
I will say, Harrison Ford did a great job with it. Even though he didn't want to be there. He didn't want to do it. I thought he still played the character very well.
Yeah, like I said, he got the lines.
Well, he kept the charisma of Solo.
He can't do the action parts of the movie, though.
There's no way he was going to be able to do that.
Yeah. That's why Poe was there killing him.
There is one scene that just sticks out in my mind, and that is the scene that I told you earlier was straight out of the Third Reich.
Yeah,
they're
all standing there,
and he's just sitting there yelling, and this Starkiller kills.
Yeah,
which lost some of its fear to me because he started lisping real goddamn bad.
No one likes General Hux.
He's like, so we will destroy them. I'm like, is this fucking Daffy? Like, is Daffy doing?
I was really hoping
it's Wabbit season.
Supreme Leader Snoke would have killed him because I don't need another movie with General Hux. No. I really don't.
I feel like he's going to be more important than we want him to be in the future.
No, you know who
maybe Kylo kills him because they have tension.
They tried to make more important than they want it to, but we kind of want it to. Phasma.
Yeah.
They tried to make her into the new Boba Fett.
Which pisses me off because I'm
so
like,
pointless.
It makes me mad because I'm like, this is the first time an Empire-like order has given a female a rank higher than all the other stormtroopers. I'm like, I want to know how. I want to know why. I want to know more about this character.
You had to read the Finn
story. She was in the Knights of Ren.
Which is fine. Yeah, but was that fuck movie? No.
See, but the problem with her was she wasn't as fleshed out as she was supposed to be. They killed her, air quotes, too quickly, and they gave her too much of a unique design with no real reason to it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, see, that here's my... It's a movie. Show me it.
Yeah.
A movie's the show. Don't half-ass explain something and then be like, well, go read this. It's like, no, that's not what you're here for.
Because I kind of get the feeling what they're going to do is she's going to survive the trash compactor just like they did in episode 4.
I didn't know she's in the trash compactor.
Yeah, you never really see anything happen.
They don't show it happen. I'm saying she's going to survive it. Then she's going to come back as like a bounty hunter or something looking for Finn to get revenge or some dumb shit.
I swear to God, if they don't film her down in there and she finds a nice couch, I'm going to be pissed off.
Really?
She's like, you know, you Febreze this, wash us on the stage, you got a good couch.
You know, I will say, before I watched Force Awakens, I went back and I watched the 4, 5, and 6. And I realized how well Family Guy covered.
Oh, yeah. It's like point for point. They got the correct swipes too. Like star, they want the side swipe. They got the inverted box swipe. They did them all.
Yeah.
I will say, I really like the opening with the Star Destroyer coming over the screen.
Yeah,
that was nice.
Why does C-3PO have a red arm?
Because he's now Big Boss.
Is that like the real answer? Or
no? Okay. He's not looking Big Boss from Metal Gear Solid. Okay?
But it's hey, I didn't read all that.
It's literally the same arm.
It is.
And it's the same exact color.
But did they explain that in any of the things you've read? Why does he have a red arm?
Not that I can remember.
Because they seem like they really wanted to point that out. I mean, it was comedy
relief. You might not recognize me, Mr. So Knows. I have a red arm now. And then it's like, no, I recognize that gay robot voice anywhere.
I mean, he could have just said, you might not recognize me because it's been so long. But no, he's like, no, I got a red arm.
Well, that's the joke.
Don't mind me cock blocking you right now.
I get that, but it felt like there was more to it than that.
Yeah, and he leaves. I'm just like, what happened? Where's your other arm?
Luke took it. He was so mad.
Yeah, he's probably like, that's it. I'm taking your beaten arm. One more blast off for you, C-3PO. And you know what? I'm powering down R2 while I'm gone, so you can't do any crazy shit to him either.
See, C-3PO was mad because R2-D2 was banging the Death Star. Remember when he was uploading the file?
Yeah. He's just outside the Death Star like, cling, cling, cling.
No, he was inside the Death Star.
No, he went outside. He did it the real way. He went behind it. Cling.
How was I supposed to know that was an electric outlet?
Oh, R2.
Okay, and my last
high five on that shit. Yes!
He can't the dang Dagobah system!
My last what the fuck moment in the film.
I'm getting my checkups on Alderaan.
Is how is that lightsaber underneath that new cantina?
It's not an... It's... If you noticed, that's actually the Rebel base from Return of the Jedi.
Mm-hmm.
And they just... Since the Rebel doesn't no longer have to be there, she just like, fuck it, I'm making a cantina here.
Okay, well that's fine.
And I guess
why is a lightsaber in a chest in the basement?
He may have just left it there because he didn't need it. Or he may have left it with somebody who then... Because shit gets apparently traded and sold throughout this fucking universe. Like,
yeah, that's true.
Like goddamn Pogs or something.
Yeah, how the hell did he...
P-O-G-S! toys from the 90s.
How did Ren get Vader's helmet? Because he was on that funeral pyre with it.
Maybe just gone and got it. I don't know. Who cares?
But I'm just saying, time-wise, it's just like, kind of like we're just walking around like Han Solo's kid. He's like, what's that? Mine. And it's just like, as he's growing up, he's like, that looks badass. I'm going to be a bad guy.
You have to think that when he decided, yes, I'm going to become a Sith, and because of Vader, you know, being his grandfather, he was like, I need something to associate myself better with this side of the Force and with my grandfather, who I look up to and respect, which I don't understand why? Considering if you want to be a Sith, Darth Vader's not really a great choice.
No.
He kind of killed Darth Sidious.
Yeah.
Well, you know.
It doesn't make any sense.
Should always go Maul.
No, you never go Maul.
He was a really cool character that
he was
just underused to the max.
He was totally underappreciated in the Star Wars universe.
He got to kill, what the fuck's his name? Not Qui-Gon Jinn. I know his Star Wars name. I mean the actor's name.
Liam Neeson.
He got to kill Liam Neeson.
Which was Zeus. Which it's a big kill.
Probably the most meh Jedi of all time.
Probably, yeah.
I mean, he trained Obi-Wan, but Obi-Wan was kind of a dick.
Yeah.
Just like fucking Anakin. That whole area. By the way, I don't know if I told you about this. I think I did. But it's fucking hilarious that in episode 4, I believe it was, Obi-Wan's like, yeah, your father wanted you to have this lightsaber. He used to slaughter young children.
Dude, when you piece together the story like that happened through the prequels, and then you like watch that like meeting of him and like Luke, you're like, dude, you are lying out your fucking teeth right now.
Yeah.
Like, when you piece it all together, it's like, I barely knew your father. I'm like, bullshit. So, all right. We're going to end this here, because this is going to take me like 5 hours to render this episode. So, if you're still with us, thank you so much for sticking through our Star Wars rants. And also, I want to remind you, you can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/grindedword. You can find us on Twitter. You can follow us on Twitter at twitter.com/BigG, Grinded Word. Check out our YouTube channel, youtube.com/C/GrindedWord. And share us with all your friends, because we'd like to build a nice big community and talk to you guys about all the stuff that we talk about and get your opinions. I want this.
And we know that you guys got Star Wars opinions.
Yeah.
Everyone does.
Put them in our comments. Because I do respond. I read the comments. So.
He'll come to your house, serve you tea, and talk about it with you.
Yeah.
And I'll probably
tell you,
not.
I'll tell you when
no
you're
guarantees.
Wrong.
No guarantees.
Lord of Dunes of Pecan Sandies. It's,
and I'll tell you when you're wrong.
First of all, if you're going to get a cookie, never one with a girl's name. They'll always let you down.
It's true. Go Pecan Sandies.
That's an office joke, by the way.
Is it?
Yeah.
Maybe I got to start watching this show. I'm missing out. So. Thank you guys so much for listening, and we'll catch you in the next episode.